Now time to start. So hello everyone. I'm Yoshi Kobayashi from CIP, and I'm working for Toshiba also. And today I'd like to make a presentation about our project, which is called Chibi Infrastructure Platform. And the title is How to Make Smart City Stay Smart with Open Source Project. So first of all, yeah, things change a lot around yourself. Now many systems connected to internet, not just our connected cars, but also industry and smart city, which means everything around yourself will be connected together to optimize the world. So do you know what the civil infrastructure is? Anyone? All right. There are many kind of hidden industrial IoT systems around the world. For example, transportations. Yeah. Every day, maybe some of you using trains, which controlled by operating systems. And now we are using Linux to control train systems. And energy. Can you imagine the turbine, big turbine, controlled by Linux? So which means electricity comes from an energy power plant runs on Linux. And other stuffs also runs on Linux. For example, building automations and broadcastings, and also almost yourself using smartphone, and smartphone relying on telephone network. So that kind of network also runs by Linux and many and industry stuff. So these kind of things are difficult to see, but all runs for your life. So which means which is our civil infrastructure systems. And if we focus on smart cities, we consider the quality of the services. To provide smart cars, each car able to run by themselves, and the controlling systems also provides their services by the best effort basis. But for industrial IoT systems, which may something like a power plant, we should consider about the quality of services. Because if power distribution stopped, which makes huge issues for our life. So industrial IoT systems need to run 24 hours every day and cannot stop, and also ensure the quality of services. So this is a kind of smart city. this is very, very old power distribution systems. But inside this kind of systems, also we are using softwares based on Linux. But there are many issues to ensure the quality for a long time. Once we created power plant and created some software for power plant, we have to consider how many years to run this kind of systems. And for example, power plant runs on more than 30 years. This is just normal. This is a quite difference between smartphone and power plant. And now we have to consider about security. Usually, the power plant doesn't connect to the internet directly. But to optimize our life, we should consider to run this kind of systems with network. For example, if the power plant able to optimize by power consumption every home or every town and everyone. So that means everyone able to provide the data to optimize the power plant. So in that case, we have to consider about security for million devices. So there are three main key challenges to ensure the civil infrastructure systems are stable enough. The first one is industrial grade. To ensure the industrial grade, we have to enhance the reliability for open source softwares. And next one is sustainability. Once we created the product, we should to use this kind of system more than 10 years or sometimes 30 years. So we have to consider about the long-term stability. And the last one is, of course, security. We should consider about the fix the security issues over time during the product lifetime. So, but to solve this kind of key challenges, we also consider about the complexity of the softwares. About 20 years ago, when we create the products, small products for infrastructure, we just create everything by ourselves. But now things change to use open source software to create this kind of product. And now we also consider about the connectivity to connect the internet or to optimize our life, which makes quite complicated software systems underneath of our applications. So, to create our civil infrastructure systems products, we are using Linux. But many companies also using Linux, but they also have the same issues. So as you can see here, there are many kind of penguins. So if we create the different penguins every time, this makes quite difficult to maintain all penguins at the same time. And in software world, there are no common solutions for base systems. So this is why we created Civil Infrastructure System Platform project. And CIP aims to establish the open source base layer for industrial systems. So this is the first time to say open source base layer. I'd like to explain what the open source base layer is. Open source base layer is located under the Linux distributions. This is kind of very, very fundamental systems for every product. So that includes Linux kernel, of course, and a set of base important packages. For example, C language library. I think many are everywhere using this kind of libraries. So we should consider what kind of libraries or what kind of utilities are commonly used for industrial systems. That is categorized to CIP core packages. And both CIP kernel and CIP core packages we called base layer. And on top of the base layer, there are many packages able to use with CIP base layer to create our applications. So this is how we use our open source base layer inside the company. So CIP will provide the CIP base layer, and on top of that, we can use many kind of open source software packages based on your requirement. So this is a kind middle line Yeah, this part. And on top of that, this is very, very important for business units. This is the value for the product. So this shape is how we use open source base layer with other open source projects. And based on our experience, we can reduce about 70% of our effort to create our products based on our CIP base layer, because CIP focuses to maintain the this base layer, and this is a very fundamental part. And many people join to maintain this effort. That's able to reduce the cost for development. So CIP is open source project. There are member companies are there, and now we have 8 member companies to create our open source base layer. And as you can see, Siemens or Toshiba, these kind of companies are creating many kind of CIP infrastructure systems. And SOC vendor is Renesas, so they providing industrial grade SOCs. So these kind of companies are currently joining the CIP as a member. And we have some budget because we paid some membership fee, and that budget we usually use to hire some developers and also to fund our important projects. So this is a technical map. So we have to do many kind of stuff, not just the maintenance, because we still consider current open source is not enough to directly use for our product. So there are many enhancements will be done by CIP. For example, real-time support is good example. Real-time support is we are using real-time patch, but Linux kernel real-time patch set is not upstream yet, which means when we use Linux kernel with real-time patch set, we have to maintain both kernel trees, which makes twice as cost or more. So we contribute to real-time Linux project. So this is the kind of how we are working with that. And as you see, we currently have only 8 members, so we have to prioritize our technical issues. And our first target was super long-term support kernel. Then increase our focus to build our open source base layer. And this slide shows CIP's governance. So we have a normal open source project, which have a governing board. Governing board decides the project directions. But under the governing board, we have technical steering committee. So technical steering committee is very important committee, because inside the TSC, we discuss a lot how we focus and what kind of topic will be focused in CIP project. And currently we have 6 projects inside the CIP. And the first one is a super long-term support kernel, and then increase the project. And the latest one is software update working group. So I'd like to explain how we work together with open source project to ensure the CIP base layer. So this slide shows how we work with open source project. Because CIP is open source project, but we don't reinvent our wheel from scratch. There are many open source projects doing similar stuff or doing important stuff for CIP. If we find that kind of project, we work together. So we have strict rule. The rule is upstream first. This is quite opposite considerations in between maintenance and upstream first. But upstream first is very, very important policy for CIP. If we want to maintain something, we have to include the fix to upstream. This is upstream first policy for CIP doing. And once our fix or our important device drivers or our important key features are included in upstream, then we start to backport to CIP kernel. So if we fragment it with open source upstream project and CIP, it also causes serious issues to maintain the CIP kernel or other layers. And other than the kernel layer, we are also using many kind of open source projects, and the most important one is Debian, because the Debian is a kind of a CIP reference distributions. And for testing, we contribute to the Lava and Kernel CI and the other open source projects as well. So, to ensure our project, this circle is very important. And this is what CIP is doing now. So this is actually a development phase structure for the CIP SLTS kernel. So first, we upstream our required features and also bug fix to mainline and also stable trees. So we are just doing as normal. For example, if you try to find CIP project inside the Linux stable mailing list, you can't find. But our maintainer actually helping their reviews for Linux stable trees. And once LTS kernel is available, we merge it the fixes to our CIP kernels. And CIP kernel have some device driver enhancement and also some feature enhancement. Because during our support period, sometimes we would like to have some security enhancement to make our systems more secure. So this kind of very small and very important features only able to backport to our CIP kernel. And currently we have two CIP kernels, and the first one was released I think around 3 years ago. That was a 4.4 based kernel. And currently we maintain a CIP kernel, and the latest one is 4.19. So both kernel is maintained by CIP and with stable kernel team. So the latest one just released yesterday, and version is that one. So this is a bit different, because on real-time Linux patch is not upstream yet. So we first funded to real-time Linux project as a gold member. And not just funding, we also joined their activities. For example, 4.4 is maintained by CIP members, and Yeah, based on that, we created CIP-based RT kernel. So this is a kind of funding and development. And the next one is a CIP testing. So at the beginning, we would like to test by ourselves. That means we created our own environment based on open source software using Lava and Kernel CI. But after that, we reconsider our testing effort to individual persons to distributed environments. And now we also using Lava and Kernel CI, but our testing environment is now located on AWS, and every day we test our CIP kernel. And the testing result is available on internet as well. So all testing effort is open. And fourth one is CIP core. So CIP core aims to provide the implementations, which means a kind of reference distributions for CIP core users based on Debian. So we are using Debian source code and Debian binaries to create a CIP open source base layer. The reason why we choose Debian is Debian is very friendly for embedded systems, and also there are some long-term support projects which called Debian LTS. So if you are going to Debian LTS project, you can find CIP logo on their website, because we work together with Debian LTS project persons. And currently we have two profiles. So one is a tiny profile, which makes very, very small footprint root file systems for IoT sensors or something like small product. And the other one is generic profile, which able to use IoT gateways. Now IoT gateways have more than 32 megabytes or 32 gigabytes, something like that. That kind of storage and also memory on the machine, so which is able to use a generic profile. And the latest status of the CIP core is you can test CIP core based on, now you can download from GitLab. And also we are using CIP core to test CIP kernel every day. So this is a status for that. So from now on, things are a little bit changed. So we launched the security working group. As I said, we are fixing the security fixes. But the other point of view, to create the secure product is also important, which requires a development process and also development document or something like that. Now there are quite important standards is available, which called IEC 62443, which is a generic cybersecurity standard. And that was published at February. So this is very new security standard. But many product developer want to apply this standard for our product. In that case, every developer need to ensure to meet this standard, which requires many testing effort and also many documentations. So we decide to create many test cases and also reference implementations to fit this standard. That means if you, once we publish our result, you can use directly to your product, which makes more than 50% of cost reductions for development for this security standard. So the latest status is we just started the feasibility study, because this is only published in last February. So now it's about 6 months now. But we already created some test cases, around 40 test cases with document. So this kind of document will be present Open Source Summit Japan in next month. And the last one is a software updating work group. So software updating is important because now many devices connected, which means that we have to manage that kind of devices and also need to update to fix the critical issues for IoTs. And currently we are focusing to use open source softwares in that effort. And we are using SW Update for the updating systems, and we are using Hawkbit to manage the old devices. So this is also just started recently, but will be demonstrated in next month. So we currently actively development for the demonstrations. So let me summarize my presentations. So, kernel maintenance is important, of course, but to maintain the kernel, we have to consider about upstream. So we currently are using upstream first policy to maintain the Linux kernel more than 10 years. So 10 years is our minimum commitment, and we just should say 10 years or more. And we are doing the other activities to ensure the open source base layer for civil infrastructure systems. And this open source base layer will be able to use many kinds of products, not just a power plant, not just a train. I think this base layer will be used everything. So if you are interested in our products, please feel free to contact me and please join us. And there are many information available here. And thank you very much for to attending my presentations. And any questions? No? There are 5 minutes to go. All right. Okay, that's a good question. The question was, are there any membership fee to join this project? So there are two membership level is available. And first one is Platinum, which is $200,000 per year. And Silver membership is a bit different. The maximum is $20,000, but depending on company size. For example, if your company is quite small, less than 50 members, which reduced to around $5,000 per year. So this is a membership fee to join the CIP project. But yeah, please consider to join Linux Foundation, because Linux Foundation membership fee is also required to join this project. Thank you. And any other questions? Anything, welcome. All right, thank you very much.